In this video, I'll be introducing new notation for adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing functions, as well as defining composite functions and that notation, and we'll be doing the following 8 problems. This is part 6 of functions. We're going to be discussing the algebra of functions and composite functions. We're going to be using this new notation. We've already added, subtracted, multiplied, and divided functions, but we just have this new way of writing it. The shortcut is on the left, so f plus g in parentheses of x really just means f of x plus g of x, and similarly for the next 3. And then composite function, that's a new concept. We use a little circle here between the 2 functions, and it means f of g of x. So let's say that f of x was equal to x squared minus 9, and g of x was equal to x plus 3. Put the video on pause and see if you can figure out how you would find these 4 problems here. All right, f plus g of x, what does that mean? That means f of x plus g of x. But what's f of x? F of x up there is x squared minus 9 plus g of x is x plus 3. So we just add like terms, and we get x squared plus x minus 6, and that's our answer. All right, next one, f minus g of x. Well, we're just going to be subtracting instead of adding, right? That means f of x minus g of x, but we do have to remember our parentheses here. So we have x squared minus 9, that's f of x, but we're going to have to subtract g of x. So we're subtracting the quantity x plus 3. So that'll give us x squared minus 9. And then we're going to have to distribute that minus sign, minus x, minus 3. So this gives us x squared minus x minus 12. All right, f times g of x. All right, that means f of x times g of x. So that means x squared minus 9 times x plus 3. Well, this is the product of 2 binomials, so we can do the FOIL method. First, x squared times x is x cubed. The outer, x squared times 3 is plus 3x squared. The inner, minus 9 times x is minus 9x. And the last, negative 9 times 3 is minus 27. And that's as simplified as we can go because there are no like terms. So there's our answer for that one. And the last one, f of x divided by g of x. We would do f of x, which is x squared minus 9, over x plus 3. Now, in order to simplify this, we're going to have to factor to see if we can cancel anything. So the numerator is a difference of 2 squares, x plus 3 times x minus 3. And then the x plus 3's cancel. So I have x minus 3 over 1. And so the answer is just x minus 3. So that's how we would do those 4 problems. This is just a shorthand notation. We've actually been doing this already. Here are the same functions for f of x and g of x. Why don't you try doing g minus f of x and g divided by f of x. You do need to put the parentheses around the g minus f and the g over f. You also have to put the parentheses around the x when you're working with functions. So try these. Okay, so this time we're doing g of x minus f of x. So g of x is x plus 3, and now we're subtracting f of x. So you need to put that in parentheses. We're replacing f of x with x squared minus 9, and that'll give us x plus 3, and distribute our minus sign, negative x squared plus 9. I'm going to move this down, a little more room. And now I'm just going to put this in descending order. So I'm going to put negative x squared plus x plus 12. And that's our answer. Hopefully you got that as well. All right, what about g over f of x? So g of x over f of x, that's what it means, correct? G of x is x plus 3, and f of x is x squared minus 9. So the difference here is what's in the numerator and the denominator. The factoring is going to be the same. We have an x plus 3 in the numerator, and x plus 3 times x minus 3 in the denominator. So let's see, those x plus 3's cancel, but keep in mind you're going to have a 1 in the numerator. So we have 1 over x minus 3. There's one other thing you have to be careful of. In your original problem, x squared minus 9 was in the denominator, and remember, x cannot, I'm sorry, the denominator can't equal 0. So if you look at the original, the denominator, you take what's in the denominator and set each factor equal to 0, and this tells you also that x cannot be 3 or negative 3. So just keep that in mind because the original function right here, that would give you a 0 in the denominator. So if you were trying to graph this, you would have either a hole or an asymptote at those values for x, so it's not going to be a nice smooth function or a continuous function, I should say. All right, let's go on to composite functions. We'll take the same two functions, f of x equals x squared minus 9 and g of x equals x plus 3. And we're going to find f of g of x. So remember what that means? You have to have this little circle. It's not a dot. That means f of g of x. Okay, so that means f of, well, what's g of x? G of x is x plus 3. And now I want to know what f of x plus 3 is. I have to look at my function for f up here. Okay, and I'm going to plug that in. I'm sorry, I'm going to plug x plus 3 in for this x right here. Okay, so I'm going to plug this x plus 3 in to that function for x. A little tricky. So instead of x, I'm plugging in x plus 3, squaring it, and then subtracting 9. Okay, so what's that going to give me? Well, you need to multiply x plus 3 times x plus 3. You could do that on scratch paper. That'll give you x squared plus 6x plus 9. And then I'm going to subtract 9 so that my final answer will be x squared plus 6x. Okay. This one's easier. G of x, g of f of x. All right, so why don't you try that? Keep in mind the original functions are f of x is x squared minus 9 and g of x equals x plus 3. Try this one. All right, so what do we get here? This means g of f of x, which is g of, okay, what's f of x? Oh, that's x squared minus 9. So I'm going to have to plug in that into the g of x formula. Just so you remember, g of x is x plus 3. Just keep that in mind because I'm going to have to go down the page here a little. So what does that mean? In place of x right here, I'm going to put in the x squared minus 9. Okay, so I'm going to plug this in to the for the you know, the rule for g of x. So I'm going to put in x squared minus 9 for x. So I'm writing x squared minus 9, and then I've got plus 3. So this gives you x squared minus 6.